Welcome back, friends. Let's go for financial management capitalization problems again. So I'll be taking you to new type of problems. In my last video, you might have seen we have learned how to solve smallest problems, that is capitalization values, book value of shares. We have learned how to find out them, how to find the net assets available to equity shareholders, etc. Okay, so I had given you some assignment. Hope you have done it so that you are perfect and we can proceed further. Okay, so I am considering these as problems of capitalization of 15 marks questions. Okay, why I am saying 15 marks is, as per the university syllabus and the exams, these are the problems which appear or which are assigned 15 marks. Okay. Yes. The following is the statement of assets and liabilities of ABC Limited. So I am giving you the statement of assets and liabilities over here. We have particulars, note column, amount column, and total column. Okay, so all of us know the format of statement of assets and liabilities. So in firstly, we have equity and liability. In that, shareholders' funds. Within that, share capital, note 1, 1,25,000. Reserves and surplus, note 2, 50,000. So total shareholder fund is 1,75,000. Okay. Second one, current liabilities. In that I have taken trade payable, note 3. The amount is 25,000. Okay. So the total of equity and liabilities is total 2 lakhs. Second part comes is assets. Non-current assets, in that you have fixed assets. Within that, tangible assets, note 4, it is 1,50,000. Second one, current assets, have trade receivable, note 5, it is 50,000. So the total of assets comes to 2 lakhs. So this is a statement of assets and liabilities. It is balanced. You can see the equity and liabilities are 2 lakhs. And the assets are 2 lakhs. It is balanced. Okay. So next we'll see what are these notes, what are the details. Yes, notes to accounts. Note 1, share capital, equity capital, 1,000 shares of rupees 100 each, that is 1 lakh. 10% preference capital, 250 shares of rupees 100 each, 25,000. So share capital is 1,25,000. Okay. Next, note 2, reserves and surplus. In that, reserves is 50,000. So the total comes to 50,000, reserves and surplus. Note 3, trade payable, creditors, trade payable, that is 25,000. Note 4, tangible assets. We have land and building, 50,000. Furniture, 25,000. Plant and machinery, 75,000. So together, tangible assets come to 1,50,000. Note 5, you have trade receivable, that is debtors, 50,000. So trade receivables total is 50,000. Okay. So these are the given data. Now we'll see here. The normal rate of return in case of similar business is 10%. This is the rate of return. 10% is the rate of return. Ascertain whether the company is overcapitalized, undercapitalized, or fairly capitalized. Okay. When the earnings available to equity shareholders are 12,500, 20,000 and 15,000. This is the problem. You have been given a statement of assets and liabilities without the values. And the normal rate of return of similar business is given, that is 10%. What you have to ascertain whether it is overcapitalized, undercapitalized or fairly capitalized. When the earnings are 12,500, 20,000 and 15,000. Okay. So let us see how to solve this problem. Hope you are very clear with the problem. So a problem well understood is of salt. All of you know this. So hope you have understood what is given and what you have to find out. So let's find the solution for this problem. So I have just framed out certain steps over here. The steps for ascertainment of capitalization status of the company with the different earnings. So as we have we know that in the problem three different types of earnings are given. That is, we have to find out the capitalization status when the earnings are 12,500, 20,000 and 15,000. So here we'll see what are the steps. First, you have to find net assets available to equity shareholders. Calculate the net assets available to equity shareholders. Secondly, find the book value of equity shares of the company. Then you have to find the real value of equity shares of the company when the earnings are 12,500, 20,000 and 15,000. Okay, so let's start calculating. So friends, here firstly I am going to calculate the net assets available to equity shareholders. So there are two different methods, so I'll be going for both the methods. First one is total assets, that is 2 lakhs. So this total assets we have taken from here. This is the total assets. This is the problem. From problem I am taking 2 lakhs less preference share capital. So here we can see in note 1, this is the first part, shareholders funds, share capital, note 1, 1,25,000. When we studied it in detail, in the note it is given, note 1, 10% preference share capital, that is 250 shares of rupees 100 each, this is 25,000. Okay, that 25,000 I have taken over here. Clear about this? Next, current liabilities. 25,000, it is given here, trade payable 25,000. So that 25,000 is taken over here. So these two together is 50,000. So from 2 lakhs we are going to deduct 50,000 and net assets available for equity shareholders is 1,50,000. Clear about this? So we'll see another method to find the net assets available to equity shareholders. Here we are taking equity share capital 1 lakh. From where did we get this? The problem, it is given shareholders funds, share capital 1,25,000. So in the note 1, we are seeing here equity capital, that is 1000 shares of rupees 100 each. This is 1 lakh. This 1 lakh I have taken over here. Okay. Then reserves and surplus 50,000. So here you can see reserves and surplus. Reserves is given 50,000. This 50,000 is taken over here. Okay. In this method, we are going to add these two and the total is 1,50,000. Okay. For confirmation, we can see that method 1 is also 1,50,000. By method 2 also, we have come to a figure called as 1,50,000. So the net assets available to equity shareholders is 1,50,000. Clear about this? Yes. Now we'll find out the book value of shares. Calculation of book value of shares. So the formula, I think all of you are perfect. In my last video, I have given you 16 assignments. If you have done all those things, you are totally perfect with the formula. So what is that? Book value of shares is equal to net assets available to equity shareholders by number of equity shares. Okay. In our last slide, you have seen the calculation of net assets available to equity shareholders. I have brought the table over here and we have come to a value of 1,50,000. So book value of shares is equal to 1,50,000. That is the net assets available to equity shareholders. This I have taken over here. Divided by number of equity shares. So here you can see note 1, equity capital is 1000 shares of rupees 100 each. So this 1000 I have taken over here, 1000 equity shares. So 1,50,000 divided by 1000 shares, we come to a figure of 150 per share. So the book value of shares is equal to rupees 150 per share. Clear about this? Yes, now we'll find out the real value of equity shares. Now we know the book value of shares. Book value of shares is rupees 150. Okay. So now we have to find out the real value of shares with when the earnings are 12,500 and two different other earnings have been given to us. First, we'll find out this when the earnings are rupees 12,500. So, capitalized value is equal to expected earning divided by rate of return into 100. All of you know this. So, capitalized value is 12,500 divided by 10. From where did you get this 12,500? I have taken it from here. When the earnings are 12,500, this I have taken over here. So, when this is our expected earnings and 10% is the rate of return which is given in our problem. Into 100, we come to a figure rupees 1,25,000. Okay. So, what is this 1,25,000? This is the capitalized value. Why do we require this? Because we require this in the calculation of real value of shares. What are these real value of shares? It is calculated by dividing capitalized value of earnings divided by number of equity shareholders. So now, what is this capitalized value of earnings? This is 1,25,000. From where did you get this? You got it from here. 1,25,000. Okay. Capitalized value of earnings divided by equity shareholders. That is number of equity shareholders. This we have in the problem. There are 1,000 equity shareholders. So 1,25,000 divided by 1,000, we come to a figure rupees 125 per share. What is this 125 per share? It is the real value of share. Okay. So here we'll see what is the position of the company. Now, the position of the company when your earnings are 12,500. Okay. So, here we'll see the company is overcapitalized. Here we are seeing that the company is overcapitalized. Why it is overcapitalized? Because the book value of shares is what? Rupees 150. It is more than the real value of shares, which is rupees 125. Okay. When the book value of shares are more than the real value of shares, the company is said to be overcapitalized. Clear about this? You can just go through all these points and try to solve it. Okay, we'll see for the next different value of earnings. So the second one is when the earnings are 20,000. When you have 20,000 earnings, what is the real value of share? That we'll see. So, we'll go back to our formula. Capitalized value is equal to expected earnings divided by rate of return into 100. So, capitalized value is equal to 20,000 is the expected earning. From where did you get? I've taken it from here. 20,000 divided by rate of return. This is given in the problem into 100. So, how much you will get? It is 2 lakhs. What is this 2 lakhs? It is the capitalized value. Okay. Now we will find out real value of shares. Real value of shares is equal to capitalized value of earnings divided by number of equity shareholders. So the real value of shares is 2 lakhs. From where did you get this 2 lakhs? I have taken it from here. That is the capitalized value of equity sorry, capitalized value of earnings divided by what? Number of equity shareholders. This is our number of equity shareholders given in the problem. So 2 lakhs divided by 1000, you come to a figure rupees 200 per share. So what is this 200 per share? This is the real value of share. What is our book value? All of you remember, it is rupees 150. So now say the position of the company. The company is what? Undercapitalized. Why? Because the book value of shares, which is 150, is less than the real value of share, that is 200. 150 is less than 200, so it is undercapitalized. Clear about this? In the first case, when it was 12,500, we got it as overcapitalized. When it is 20,000, it is undercapitalized. Now we'll go for the next one. The third case, when the earnings are 15,000. So we have seen 12,500, we have seen 20,000. When it was 12,500, the company is overcapitalized. When it was 20,000, the company is undercapitalized. Now we'll see what happens when it is 15,000. So same calculation, capitalized value is equal to expected earning divided by rate of return into 100. So capitalized value is 15,000. I have taken it from here. 10% given in the problem into 100. So we get 1,50,000. What is this 1,50,000? This is the capitalized value when the earnings are 15,000. So now real value of shares is equal to capitalized value of earnings divided by number of equity shareholders. So real value of shares is equal to 1,50,000 divided by 1000. From where did you get this? I have taken it from here. What is this? This is the capitalized value of earnings divided by 1000 equity shares. It is given in the problem. So this is equal to rupees 150 per share. What is this 150 per share? This is the real value of shares. Okay. Now we'll see the position of company. The company is fairly capitalized. Why it is fairly capitalized? Because book value is 150 and real value is also 150. So book value is equal to real value. Now we say that the company is fairly capitalized. Okay, clear about this? Just go through these points. So let us go for the abstract of our problem. So first we found the net assets available to equity shareholders, that is rupees 1,50,000. Book value of equity shares of a company is rupees 150 per share. Next we have found the real value of equity shares of the companies when, first one, when the earnings are 12,500, capitalized value is rupees 1,25,000. Real value of share has come to rupees 125 per share. So what is the position? The company is overcapitalized as book value of share is more than the real value of shares, that is rupees 125. Second one, when the earnings are 20,000, the capitalized value was 2 lakhs. Real value of share is rupees 200. So here we said the company is undercapitalized. It is undercapitalized. Why? As the book value of share, that is 150, is less than the real value of share, that is 200. So it is undercapitalized. When the earnings are 15,000, capitalized value is 1,50,000. Real value of share is rupees 150 per share. The company is fairly capitalized as the book value 150 is equal to the real value of share, that is 150. It is fairly capitalized. So we came to the conclusion that with different earnings we have found the real value of share. The conclusion is when the book value is more than real value, the company is overcapitalized. When the book value is less than the real value, it is undercapitalized. when the book value of share is equal to real value of share, it is fairly capitalized. So this problem should be clearly understood. Try to solve each and every point clearly. Then you can do any number of problems based on this. Okay. So I am giving you one problem as an assignment. So try to solve this problem. It is based on the same method what we have followed for the problem one. Same, the following is a statement of assets and liabilities of DCM Limited. So here I have given equity and liabilities, shareholders funds, share capital 5,50,000, non-current liabilities, that is long-term borrowings, note 2, 2 lakhs, trade payables, we have 50,000. So the total equity and liabilities is 8 lakhs. When you come for assets, non-current assets, fixed assets, in that tangible assets is 8 lakhs. Okay. So assets is also 8 lakhs. So notes to the accounts. Note 1, share capital, equity capital, 4,000 shares of rupees 100 each, that is 4 lakhs. Preference share capital, 1,500 shares of rupees 100 each, that is 1,50,000. So the total share capital is 5,50,000. Note 2, long term borrowings, 8% debentures, we have 2 lakhs. Okay. So the long term borrowings are 2 lakhs. Trade payables, creditors, 50,000. Tangible assets, sundry assets, 8 lakhs. Okay. Now, the normal rate of return in this case of similar business is 10%. Ascertain whether the company is overcapitalized, undercapitalized, or fairly capitalized. When the earnings available to the equity shareholders are 20,000, 60,000, and 40,000. Okay. This is exactly the same type of problem that you have solved just now. So try to solve this problem. You'll become more perfect. Okay. Yes. Thank you, friends, for watching this video. Hope you have understood the problems. Hope I am very clear in explaining the problems. So you can comment so that I can improve myself. You can follow my other videos also for some more problems and next chapters also. Some more problems are explained in my next video, and later on we'll start with capital structure. Okay. Thank you.